The story of Saimo Heiha, the White Death of Finland. Finland holds an interesting and often underappreciated role in World War II history, being the only nation in history to defend itself against the huge Russian army. Many amazing stories and fascinating figures have emerged from this period, and none more remembered than Saimo Heiha, also known as the White Death of Finland. This is his riveting story. Early years and training. Heiha was born on December 17, 1905 on a farm in the Rojavi province of South Karelia, which would later see some of the heaviest fighting of World War II and partially become part of Russian territory. Growing up on a farm in the harsh Finnish wilderness made him hardy, hard-working, and patient. In 1925, Heiha was drafted for a year of military service. He displayed his military prowess early on and after only 1 year had already advanced to the rank of corporal. Later, Heiha joined the Finnish Civil Guard and discovered his talent and passion for shooting. He reportedly spent all his free time outside practicing his shots. Eventually he could hit 16 targets per minute from 500 feet, 152 meters, making him ideal as a sniper in the war which was fast approaching. War breaks out. The winter war began in Finland in 1939, when Russia took the opportunity to regain the territory that had once been theirs. The Russian army probably assumed that such a tiny country like Finland would be easy to take. What they didn't count on was the Finnish concept of sisu, which roughly translates to guts or determination. Heiha's skills were put to good use against such overwhelming odds. At one point, he and 31 other Finnish men faced off against 4,000 Soviet soldiers. Becoming the White Death through the Winter War lasted only around 100 days. Heiha managed 500 confirmed kills during that time, and his unofficial total may be as high as 800, a record which has yet to be matched. His personal best was 40 confirmed kills in a single day. Heiha managed this thanks to military tactics that were unheard of at the time. Dressing in white camouflage allowed him to blend in with the winter scenery, and he only carried a day's worth of supplies, so that he wouldn't be weighed down. He piled up snowbanks around himself for concealment and put snow in his mouth to prevent his breath from giving him away. Rejecting more modern and advanced models, he used his own gun, a Finnish Sikko Mosin-Nagant Model 2830 rifle, with an iron sight instead of a scope, as he claimed that scopes could catch glare from sunlight and be spotted by enemy snipers. He knew his gun well enough to maintain it even during one of the coldest Finnish winters on record. Thanks to these smart and deadly strategies, Heiha quickly became feared by the Russian army, who gave him the name of the White Death, while his Finnish allies referred to him as the Magic Shooter. Role during the Winter War. The Winter War between Finland and the Soviet Union, USSR, that commenced on November 30, 1939, with the Soviet invasion of Finland saw Heiha serving as a sniper for the Finnish army. He fought in the Battle of Kola, part of the Soviet-Finnish Winter War, which took place from December 7, 1939, to March 13, 1940, in Karelia, Ladoga, Finland, serving under 6th Company of Junior 34. Defying the weather conditions with temperature ranging from minus 40 degrees Celsius, minus 40 degrees Fahrenheit, to minus 20 degrees Celsius, minus 4 degrees Fahrenheit, Heiha dressed up completely in white military camouflage thrived in eliminating as many of the Soviet soldiers as he could. The Red Army at that time was in a much unorganized state thanks to the ongoing Great Purge or the Great Terror organized by Joseph Stalin, General Secretary of the Central Committee of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union. The soldiers of the Soviet army were not equipped with white camouflage suits for much of the war and thus became more vulnerable targets of the Finnish snipers. The number of Soviet casualties in the hands of Heihe that he accomplished in less than 100 days in a time during the year with not much of daylight hours is estimated to be more than 500. This makes the average count of kills to more than 5 a day. Heihe himself counted the number of Soviet soldiers killed by him, which was affirmed by his comrades. Count of kills was considered only after ascertaining such deaths. Having said so, it was still difficult to verify the count of kills by the deadly sniper as all his targets were on the Soviet side. On February 17, 1940, his division commander A. Svensson awarded him an honorary rifle, and it was during this time that Svensson credited Heihe of confirmed sniper kills of 219 men as also a same number of fatalities through submachine gun. Finnish military chaplain Antti Rantama, a figure of the Winter War, mentioned in his diary that starting from the war till March 7, 1940, Heihe accomplished 259 sniper kills and same count of kills through machine, submachine gun. A Finnish army document accounts Heihe's sniper killing counts starting from the very onset of the Winter War. On December 22, 1939, it mentions 138 kills in 22 days. On January 26, 1940, it mentions the total count as 199 with another 61 kills in 35 days. On February 17, 1940, the total is shown as 219 with another 20 kills in 22 days. And finally on March 7, 1940, at the time when the sniper himself got severely injured, the total number of kills is mentioned as 259 with another 40 kills in 18 days. Such casualties faced by the Red Army in the hands of the unseen and unheard terror, Heihe, led them to nickname the ace marksman as the White Death. Eventually, the White Death became a famous subject matter, with Finnish newspapers often featuring the invisible Finnish war hero in their columns. Counter snipers and artillery strikes were used by the Soviets to eliminate Heihe, who was continuously posing a threat for the Red Army men. In one such effort of the Soviets on March 6, 1940, a Red Army soldier thrived in firing an explosive bullet that hit the lower left jaw of Heihe severely. Heihe's fellow soldiers mentioned that half his face was missing. He remained senseless for a few days and regained consciousness on the day the Moscow Peace Treaty was signed between Finland and the Soviet Union, that is on March 12, 1940. Following the war, Finnish Field Marshal Carl Gustaf Emil Mannerheim elevated Heihe from the rank of Alikosintai, that is corporal, to Vanriki, second lieutenant. Weaponry and techniques used by Heihe in eliminating his targets. He was given a Civil Guard rifle that was an early series Sukhoi M/2830. SN.35281 Civil Guard District Number S60974. Iron sights were given more preference by him instead of telescopic sights, as the former allowed the sniper a smaller target for the opponent, are more reliable in icy cold weather conditions, while the telescopic sights tend to become haze in such weather conditions, and is easier to hide, while lenses of telescopic sight can reflect sunlight, giving an inkling of the position of the sniper. He also didn't want to use the Soviet scoped rifle, M/9130 Porpim, as he was not trained in using them. Many a times he would hide himself by piling dense mounds of snow in front of his position. Such heap of snow also provided padding for his rifle. While sniping, he would also put snow in his mouth so that fumes from his breath does not reveal his position to the enemy. In order to moisten the jolt of his weapon, Heihei used to keep gloves between his rifle and the ground. Life after the Winter War, Heihei took several years to fully recover from the explosive bullet injury that mashed his jaw and damaged his left cheek. Following the Second World War, he evolved as a successful dog breeder and the moose hunter while continuing his life as a farmer. He also hunted with the 8th and longest serving president of Finland, Urho Kekkonen. Once he was asked whether he repented taking life of so many people. To this he answered that he was only following instructions and doing his duty and made effort to give his best. The last years of this ace sniper was spent in a municipality of Finland called Uokalahti, located in the region of South Karelia. He passed away on April 1, 2002 at the age of 96 in a war veterans nursing home in a town and a municipality of Finland called Heimona. His remains were interred in Uokalahti. The song White Death by the Swedish power metal band Sabaton that found place in their fifth studio album Coat of Arms released on October 21, 2010, was about Heihei. Legacy of the White Death. In March 1940, Heihei was struck in the jaw by an exploding bullet from a counter-sniper, putting him in an 11-day coma, which he only awoke from on the day the Winter War ended. While this injury put an end to Heihei's military career and left his face permanently lopsided, he had already achieved enough to gain numerous military awards and a record-breaking promotion to second lieutenant from Field Marshal Mannerheim, the leader of the Finnish Defence Forces. Despite ultimately ending up on the losing side of the war, Heihei's accomplishments were a great contribution to defending Finland. The Winter War ended with 1 million Russian casualties, compared to Finland's 26,000, barely making up for the 22,000 square miles, 57,000 square kilometers, of Finnish territory they had gained. In later decades, Heihei still took part in competition shooting, but otherwise lived a remarkably peaceful life, being awarded a farm by the Finnish government and picking up dog breeding as a hobby. He passed away in 2002 at the age of 96, and is still remembered in Finland as a national hero. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel.